so grateful to be here with you this afternoon. Amen. We give honor to the Master.
Yes.
And I promise you, we won't be before you very long. Amen. We give honor to God, and we give honor to this great pastor here.
Yes. Yes.
All right.
To all of my constituents in the gospel. Amen. To all these fine preachers. Y'all say amen for them.
Amen.
To all of my brothers and sisters in Christ.
All right.
Oh, come on, y'all.
Amen.
Now, if you not a saint, you're a sinner.
All right.
Amen. There's only two ways and two things that you can be.
Yes,
sir. Either a saint or a sinner. And to sinners, if we do have any this afternoon, amen.
Amen.
We are not going to prolong the hour. It's already a little bit after 3, amen. And since it's a little bit after 3, let's see, that'll give me about 6 hours, I guess. Yes, I can.
All right.
Amen. Thank Pastor Reed for introducing me. Amen.
Amen.
Pastor John Reeves. Amen.
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 God is able.
Yes, he is.
There is a word today from the book of Hebrews, the second chapter, and beginning with the first through the ninth verse. Chapter 2, verses 5-9. Of the book of Hebrews.
Gotcha.
Amen.
Amen.
Say amen when you get there.
Amen.
Are you still traveling? Will we please read this together? Amen.
Amen.
Starting with the second chapter and beginning with verse number 5 through verse number 9. Amen.
Amen.
Shall we read? Amen. Let's read. Still standing. Wait, don't sit down on me. Let's go to Isaiah, the 11th chapter, and the 6th verse. Beginning with the 6th verse. Amen. Isaiah, the first of the majors, prophets. Say amen when you get there.
Amen.
Amen. Let's read.
The Lord shall dwell with the lamb. The heaven shall lie down with the young goat.
And the bear with the young lion, and the bear with the others, and the little cow shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall graze. Their young one shall lie down together, and the lion shall draw out like an ox. And the sucking child shall lay by the hole of the ass. And the weaning child shall put his hand on the top of his head.
They shall not hurt nor destroy at all our own mountain. For the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the water covers the sea.
That's enough.
Amen.
These two titles in the book of Hebrews and the book of Isaiah.
Yeah.
I want to talk briefly from this subject here. There will be peace in the valley. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's going to be peace
in this valley
someday.
Amen.
Studying the book of Hebrews, we find that the author, no doubt, has been given to Paul. Amen. There's the account that it could have been given to others.
That's right.
Such as Apollos.
Yes.
Luke.
Yeah.
Or Barnabas.
All right.
But I like to think, according to the Pauline writings, that Paul was given the authorship of this book of Hebrews.
All right.
When we look at the word, or look at the book of Genesis, we see man in a natural state.
All right.
He's without sin, and he's without any blemish.
All right.
The Garden of Eden was the perfect place to be.
Amen. All right, sir.
It was the perfect place to live. Because God Almighty created it to be so.
That's right, amen.
And what God create, he don't make no mistakes, y'all.
Right.
Are y'all going to pray with me?
All right.
I'm not going to be too long, amen.
All right.
In the book of Genesis, the first chapter, 20 through 27, it talks about how God created the fowls of the air, the fish of the sea, the beast of the earth, the cattle and creeping things upon the earth. And then God said to the Godhead, Jesus, the angels, and also Lucifer, the devil, amen. They made up the God's head.
All right.
Now some may wonder why God have Lucifer there.
Come on.
It was because Lucifer was created by God to be the archangel of the angelic chorus.
All right.
He was supposed to be the boss, y'all, of all of the angels. So when God said, let us make man and woman in our likeness and in our image,
all right,
and let them have dominion the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the face of this earth. To somebody's surprise, guess what? Lucifer, the devil, was right there. When he heard God say that he was going to give man dominion over the earth, that sent Lucifer into a mad rage against God. Amen. So Lucifer set out to get even with God by getting man to sin against God. It tells us that God really thought a lot about his creation. The Garden of Eden was a peaceful place. The beast of the wild did not eat meat. Oh, I wish I had somebody to pray with. They ate grass, amen? Snakes didn't bite folk. There were no sharks or whale attacks. There was peace on this earth because God intended for man and woman to live forever. Man was to rule over earth. There was peace, my brothers and sisters. Peace in the valley. Now, when God created man, he created him to be a little lower than the angels. God crowned him with glory, and he crowned him with a whole lot of honor. And he did set him over the works of his hand. God only did that for just a little while. The Lord has put all things, somebody help me say all things, in subjection under man's feet. That's how come he put him in the Garden of Eden. Because man was over everything here on earth. In other words, he was the overseer. Now, according to verse number 8 in Hebrews, it says, "For in that he put all," that means everything, "in subjection under him," man, amen. He left nothing that is not under man's authority. But now we see not yet all the things put under man. We even have witnesses that God really cared and loved mankind. Job said in the book of Job 7, 17 and 18, "What is man that thou shouldest magnify him, and that thou shouldest set thine heart upon him, and that thou shouldest visit man every single morning and try him for every moment?" Every man. God is trying to get us to see that one day he's coming back. He's coming back to earth without a spot or a wrinkle. And because man has to take his rightful place in the new world order as head of the garden of the new world, God is going to give it back to man. Just like he gave it to Adam, he's going to give it back to man again. Amen. Can I get a witness here? The new world order now look like, somebody might say, look like it ought to be given to an angel. The Lord said in the book of, it said that he is not going to give it to no angel, but he's going to give it back to mankind. Can I get a witness here? And the reason why, just in case you want to know, the reason why that Satan got upset, he was there, Lucifer was right there, and he got upset. And the reason why he did was because God told man, he told man that he was going to give him dominion. I wish I had somebody to pray with me. And when he said dominion, that made Satan mad, amen. He thought he should have had that job, amen. By the archangel. That means that he was over the other angelic choruses. He thought he should have gotten a job. Amen. But God knows how to wheel and deal. Amen. The Bible said that the Lord is waiting on you and me to get it right. Amen. Before he comes back to earth. Amen. Do you know that he's coming back, church? I said, do y'all know he's on his way back? So you better get ready. Amen. The Bible said, and in Hebrews 8 said, that the Lord is giving us time to get it right. Listen if you please. But now we see not all the things put under him. That means man. My brothers and sisters, we serve a good God who will supply all of our riches according to his needs and riches in heaven. God has given us time to come to Jesus before he comes back again. We need to make up our minds before we come down to the time to die. Because when we die, we don't know and don't know him, amen, in the pardon of our sin, we will go straight to hell. Oh, yeah, come now while the time is right. He's given us time to get it together. We have lived through hurt. We have lived through pain. We have lived through backbiting and death. And still, we are holding back on the Lord. What are you waiting for today? The word says today that you hear the word and the voice of God. And it pricks your heart. You shouldn't walk away from it. Amen. Oh, yeah. You shouldn't harden your heart as they did in the provocation. You see, my brothers and my sisters, there's a lot of folk that come to church and they leave just like they came. You should never, ever come in the house of God. Amen, housetop. Amen. I said you should never come in the house of God and not get a healing. Amen. If you don't get a healing, it's your fault. And it's nobody's fault but yours if you don't get healed. In fact, you shouldn't leave here the same way that you came. There will be peace in the valley someday. Amen. Right now, man is still in his fallen state, waiting on Jesus to come back to earth to give man his rightful place. Man will be crowned with glory and honor. Then again, there will be peace in the back, just as it was before. I can see Jesus as he put one foot on the sea, one on the land, and then declare time will be no more. All who is not saved won't get saved. Let no man up on the rooftop, let him stay up there. Amen. If you're working down in the field, you might as well stay in the field. You won't have time to get back and get your cloak. Amen. If you're spinning at the wheel, just keep on weaving. Amen. Because it'll be too late. For time will be no more. I see Jesus give the keys of death to his Father. Oh, yeah. When he give the keys to God, he gonna say, there'll be no more dying. There'll be no more crying. There'll be no more weeping. There'll be no more worry. There'll no more meet my name early in the morning. There'll be no more. It'll be all howdy, howdy, and never, ever goodbye. Yeah, because Jesus is gonna come back to earth, to this new world order where we are today. Yeah. Those who have already died in Christ, they coming back. Amen. And they're going to say, let us go down to earth with you, Jesus, and give our man back his rightful place that he deserved. But there will be peace. Somebody ought to say, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. I said there will be peace one day in this valley when Jesus come back to the valley. But right now, look at somebody and just tell them, right now, I got to suffer the consequences until Jesus comes. But there will be peace when that take place. Let me go on a little bit further over to Isaiah. You see, over in the garden, this lion and this bear, they didn't attack Adam. No, no, because it was peace. Look at somebody and say, it was peace. Oh yeah, the snake didn't bite nobody because it was
peace.
Nobody got hurt by a shark attack or a whale attack because it was
peace.
My brothers and my sisters, we are going back to that same day that God is going to put man back in his rightful place. And don't worry, women, you're going to be there too. Amen. Because he took the rib out of man's side and he created that woman. Amen. Can I get a witness here? Isaiah said the wolf is going to live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the young yearlings together all by themselves. Because there's going to be peace in this valley one day. All you ought to be looking for peace right now. Some of us are misconstrued about what's going to happen, but I'm telling you right now, Jesus is going to come back with peace, and he's going to give us peace in this valley. Ain't God all right? I said, ain't he all right? The cow, amen, will feed with the bear. And you know right now, if a bear see a cow, he gonna kill her. Amen.
Amen.
Can I get a witness here? But in the last day, when Jesus come back, there's gonna be peace in the valley. The cow and the bear, they gonna eat straw together. Oh, I wish I had a prayer church this afternoon. I want some peace in the valley. The Bible said that the baby is going to play near the hole of the snake. And the young child will put his hand in the snake hole and will not get a bite on his skin in the last day. But I tell you right now, everybody's just about scared of a snake. Amen. Can I get a witness for it? The lion is going to eat straw. Oh, my.
Right.
He won't eat no more meat. Amen. He's going to eat straw because there will be peace in the valley. Can I get a witness out there? Do y'all know what I'm talking about? Is anybody looking for peace? Amen. Is anybody want some peace right now? Why don't you just shout, Jesus. Jesus, help me right now before it's too late. Amen. We ought to be telling him, thank you. Somebody ought to tell him thank you. Somebody ought to tell him thank you right now. Yeah. The earth is going to be full of the knowledge of the Lord. It ain't going to be no more devils. Amen. Hello, somebody. Oh, no. It ain't going to be no more devils. It's going to be peace in the valley. I heard old Red Foley sang a song somewhere. Some years ago, he said this. I'm tired and so weary, but I must go along till the Lord come and call me away. Oh, yeah. Well, the morning so bright, and the lamp is the light, and the night it was black as the sea. Oh, yes, there will be peace in the valley. Look at somebody and say, one day, it's going to be some peace. One day, I said, one day, one day. Thank you, Jesus. But one day, there will be peace in the valley. Yeah, well, the bear will be gentle. And the wolves will be tamed. And the lion shall lay down changed. Anybody in here want to get changed? I will be changed from the creature that I am. Is anybody in here know Jesus right now? Well, let me tell you what he did for you. He died out on Calvary's cross. Can I get a witness for him? He died out on an old rugged hill called Calvary. He died from the 6th to the 9th hour. Hung his head in the locks of his shoulder. And he died until the moon dripped down in blood. He died until the sun refused to shine. Ain't God all right, y'all? Y'all know he's all right. If you know he's all right, say yeah. Yeah. Say yes. Say yeah. He died until graves flew wide open all around Jerusalem. But didn't nobody get up out of the grave. Because the Son of God hadn't got up. They took him down off the cross and put him down in Joseph's new tomb. Stayed right there all night Friday and all day Saturday. But early, I said early, if you know anything about early Sunday morning, why don't you get up on your feet and shout glory, glory. Sunday morning, he got up out of the grave with all power, all power, all power. Somebody ought to tell him, thank you. He's on his way back, amen. Thank you. There will be peace in the valley. Oh, we're catching hell right now, y'all. Look at somebody say, we're catching hell. Guess what? Jesus is going to iron all of this stuff out. Can I get a witness? Somebody say we're worried about Donald Trump. Oh, no. Trump ain't got no power. No power for Jesus. Jesus is going to bring back the whole host and nation. Will you be ready? I said, will you be ready? Are you ready right now to go and to have peace down in this valley? Somebody ought to say, Jesus, 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 in the name of Jesus, every knee got to bow, every tongue got to confess that he is Lord. Ain't he all right? I said, ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? I can't hear you. Ain't he all right? It's gonna be peace in this valley. Oh yes, regardless of what's going on, Jesus is gonna take care of it, amen. And he's coming back after a church without a spot. All wrinkled, amen. Will you be ready? One thing about it, my brothers and my sisters, it says that the day you hear my voice, let me share something with you. You cannot hear the Lord's voice unless you know what his word is saying.
All right. All right.
Hello, somebody.
All right.
If anybody tell you anything different, that's not the Lord's voice.
All right.
If folk come to you and tell you, says, I got something to tell you, the Lord told me to tell you, I ask him, where do you find it in the Bible?
All right. All right.
Just ask him.
All right.
Amen, I'll stop.
All right. All right. All right.
Just ask them, where is it? The Lord wants us to have peace. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Down here in this valley.
Amen.
God's word.
All right.
For God's people.
Amen.
I just want to sing just a little verse of this song right here.
All right. All right.
If you don't mind, we're getting ready to get out of here.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
I am on my way to glory. Y'all help me.
Reach that other.